School districts today face an array of threats from cyber attacks, denial of service attacks, malware, and phishing emails sent to teachers, administrators, and students. How can districts prevent cyber attacks and insulate themselves from bad actors? In some cases, hackers are interested in obtaining students' personal information, but there have also been attempts to steal employees' information, W-2 forms that can be used for tax fraud and financial fraud. In other cases, hackers are interested in gaining access to district servers so they can stage denial of service attacks on other institutions. Education Week explores the nature of cyber attacks and the threats that districts face in a new special report. So what are some of the steps that districts can take to prevent cyber attacks? One step to consider is to segment your network. So if hackers access one part of your system, it should be physically disconnected from all the others so that they're not vulnerable to the same attack. Another step to take is to think about restricting administrative access to your systems. That means not allowing students, teachers, and even administrators to download software that could carry malware or other viruses that could infiltrate your whole system. Another important piece of advice is to train staff and then retrain them throughout the year to recognize phishing emails and other scams that could come to them. When districts are hit with cyber attacks, one of the primary reasons is that internal staff members don't recognize what they're seeing as a threat. As one district administrator explained to me, our biggest threat is ourselves. Another important step that a lot of districts overlook is to have an incident response plan in place up front so that you know what you're going to do if a cyber attack should strike. Which law enforcement contacts do you need to reach out to if there's a cyber breach? Does your lawyer need to know? Do you need to hire an outside consultant to help you sort through the problem? Do you have insurance in place to help pay for the costs of a breach? All of these are questions that, if you know the answers to them up front, can help save you a lot of headache on the back end. Those are just some of the practical steps that districts can take to prevent cyber attacks. For more information on cybersecurity, check out our special report at edweek.org.